had launched Swadeshi movement between the common man. And August 1942, Mahatma Gandhi started the Quit India movement, which later resulted in Independent India on the glorious day which we now celebrate as Independence Day, that is 15 August 1947. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister of India, and he said, "At the stroke of midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will await life and freedom." Nearly after 200 years of British rule, India finally won back its freedom on 15 August 1947, the birth of a new nation and a new beginning. On AIM of 15 August, the India tricolour unfolded by the Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru at Red Fort, New Delhi. Let us salute the prosperity of India and every freedom fighter who made it possible. Let us hail the glory of this wonderful country, India, as our tricolour flung everywhere high in the sky. Let us respect and salute our nation. From 70 years of independence, we progress in every field, including education, technology, finance, and many others. We children are the future of our country. We should grow responsible in a right way. Let us take a pledge on this day that we will respect our freedom for which our forefathers struggled to the extent. Also on this very special occasion, I would like to forward the thought quoted by our former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I can do it. We can do it. India can do it. Work with integrity. Grow with integrity. So let us unite for a common goal to uphold the values of our country and make it the best one in the world. If there is brightness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. If there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there is order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there is peace in the world. These are the beautiful words by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. By this, I wish everyone here a very happy Independence Day. Thank you.